It turned out to be a good thing that we waited, both for him and for me. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know if I don't do Che just before this movie, I don't mm-hmm. know if I embrace the comedy as much as I ended up embracing it. Mm-hmm. That was a real motivation for me that obviously didn't come from anything that was inherent right. in the piece. So, and as it turned out, by the time we were shooting, Matt was virtually the same age as Whitaker when the story mm-hmm. actually took place. So it was good. It was good that we waited.
And it is kind of like there are three or four layers going on at the same time, because you have this comedy that's surprisingly a real story that's also got big surprises in it. It's not, it's a complicated piece, you know, which is, I think, the biggest surprise for audiences, is they, particularly with that poster
right.
and Matt's big mug facing everybody, is like, you know, I don't think they expect to come in and get shocked over and over again by what's going on.
Well, that was my impression when I read the book. You know, the feeling that I had reading the book was that four or five times I felt I had to start over. Mm-hmm. You know, that every, my frame had to be readjusted because I just got some new information. And Kurt Eichenwald did a really great job of mm-hmm. of revealing things. It's very cinematic, mm-hmm. the book. Because he's very, very smart about how he doles out information. And so Scott and I both wanted to kind of duplicate that feeling. But it's a crazy, crazy story. Yes. I mean, the more you think about it, it really... Whitaker, when he saw the movie a few weeks ago, wrote an email to the person at Warner Brothers who'd sort of taken care of him. Mm-hmm. And he said, Ginger and I really enjoyed the movie, and we thought it was very accurate. And... boy, I did some crazy things back then.
And do we know whether he's still doing crazy things? He's still in business. He's in the...
Yeah, no, I think he's calmed down. He is, you know, he I think he's found a sort of pharmaceutical mm-hmm. cocktail that's kind of keeping him on the straight and narrow, but he seems perfectly fine.
Scott did say there was one part of the movie he didn't like so much. That his bald reveal. Well, now I'm revealing it.
What about it?
The idea that he's wearing it's kind of obvious he's wearing a wig through the movie, but that he didn't that was kind of horrifying to acknowledge that he was actually bald.
Well, I like that, of course. I mean, what was great for me was that early on in the shoot, I was talking to Matt about something, and he scratched his head, and I saw the whole thing move, and I thought, okay, now I gotta find a place for this, because mm-hmm. that's fantastic. And I decided that the place for it was in an otherwise genuinely emotional scene, which is when Ginger's upset that they're yeah. being abandoned by the FBI, and I told Matt, I said, wait until she really peaks, and then go for it. And he nailed it. It's a great piece of physical business. He's so smart.
Yeah.
You know, he really...
He's kind of this amazingly underrated actor.
Well, even though he has been Oscar nominated, even though he's been in a string of successful movies, yeah, I still feel like he's... Now people are beginning to go, he's really, really... He's a really good actor. He's mm-hmm. just a good actor. And there is not a director who's worked with him who doesn't mm-hmm. want to repeat the experience.
And he's willing to go for it. I mean, he seems to be
fearless
about... He
jumps off the cliff. He's totally yeah. fearless. Well, the Liberace movie is going to be interesting.
Which we think is actually going to happen?
Yeah, I think we got the money. So it'll be next summer.